If you photograph in JPEG, you can still use Lightroom. There are some limitations to only shooting in JPEG and just in general. For example, if you have a color cast in your image and it's a JPEG file, it's going to be very difficult to remove that color cast. Whereas with a raw photo, you can edit the heck out of the color and bring the white balance back to its normal state. So getting color accurate in camera is really important. Tone is also important. It's going to be difficult to bring back highlights and add brightness to the shadows on a JPEG file if you have to go to extremes. For the most part, if you get your color and your tone pretty close in camera, then you're going to be fine with shooting JPEG. Now let's go through the differences in Lightroom when you actually process those photos, and I'm just going to highlight a couple of them. First of all, the white balance setting is there, but it starts at zero. I have the raw counterpart to this image alongside it, and if I switch over to that real quickly, you can see that I have an actual temperature and tint setting applied, and that's just from how it was shot in the camera. I'll go back to the JPEG image. You can see that they're pretty much identical as I switch back and forth. The other major difference is in the camera calibration. If you want to change the profile, you're kind of out of luck. With a JPEG file, you pretty much only have the embedded setting available. I'll switch over to the RAW file counterpart, and you can see that I have all of those camera profiles that came with my Fujifilm X-T1. I photographed this in the Velvia or Vivid mode, but I could change it if I like. But with my JPEG file, as you can see here, that Velvia profile is embedded and burned into my image. A lot of people do like to shoot JPEG, and that's great. And you can use Lightroom in a very full capacity without having to photograph in RAW.